This video is not sponsored in any way. I researched and purchased all of the items that you see. Today I'm going to tell you all that I know about metal, screw-in lens hoods. As you can imagine, there's not that much to know, but hopefully this will give some kind of insight. These are three seemingly very similar 67mm lens hoods, but there is one subtle difference that separates these hoods. The threads are the same, there is a slight difference in weight between them, but the keen-eyed amongst you will have already noticed that the main difference is the amount of internal light reflection. These internal reflections get progressively less as we look at them from left to right. More on that in a minute. For those of you not familiar with this type of hood, they are available with different thread sizes, different tube lengths, and different shapes. This one is good for wide-angle lenses. The thread on these hoods is fairly standard, and the corresponding size will fit any lens which has a thread for a filter. You will of course have to choose the correct hood size and shape to prevent vignetting. Usually, there is a thread on the other end of the hood which is normally larger in size than the base thread. Again, this is a standard thread in which you can screw a filter or perhaps another lens hood. Now, let's talk about internal reflection. The whole reason for using a lens hood is to prevent stray light from entering the lens. So the less reflection inside the lens hood, the better. This is what separates these hoods. Here is a quick test. Let me introduce some sunshine. The first hood has a fairly large hotspot when hit by a strong light. The second hood shows a definite improvement. But finally, the Sioti lens hood, with its anti-glare oxidation treatment, actually eliminates the hotspot altogether. I must say that I'm impressed. So what do you get when you buy a Sioti lens hood? It's supplied with a lens cap of the correct size to fit the end of the lens hood. In some situations, the lens cap is unable to make contact with the front lens element should it become loose in your camera bag. This can eliminate any concern that the cap may be grinding away at the front of the lens. They also supply what appears to be a microfiber lens cloth, which I have tried and is actually quite decent. I bought mine directly from the Sioti website, as I've had issues with receiving non-genuine parts from other sources. I won't mention any names. The site is at sioti.co.co, where there's a great selection of sizes and shapes. The prices are reasonable, and they are delivered for free. I have so far received my orders within 10 days, so not bad. I use this particular Sioti lens hood with my Olympus 40-150 Pro. The actual thread is 72mm, but I first use a reducer and then the 67mm lens hood. I prefer to keep the hood at the same width as the lens, and there is no vignetting. I leave this hood on permanently. It protects the lens and, for me, eliminates the need for a protective filter of any kind. The other bonus is that the original 72mm lens cap still fits. One word of warning. Do not over-tighten these threads. You will regret it. Tighten them just enough to grip as required. You can also use the hoods with filters, as most of them come with a thread for purposes such as this. This 62mm variable ND filter has a 67mm external thread. As you can see, using a hood with a variable ND or polarizer makes it easier to turn the filters to the desired position. I hope that you found this useful. You now know as much as I do about screw-in lens hoods. Cheers.